Hello children, how are you? Children, today we are going to study the 7th standard geography's 5th lesson, that is winds. In last lesson, in lesson number 4, that is air pressure, we have studied the different points. So let's revise the points which we have studied in air pressure lesson. We have studied the definition of the air. Then we have also studied which are the factors which are influencing the pressure. We have also studied the pressure belts. What are the different areas which are joining on the map? That is called as a isobar. Afterwards, we have also taken information about the equipment called as a barometer. Why I am telling you to revise this last lesson? Because these lessons are interconnected with each other. Air pressure lesson is interlinked with the wind lesson. If you have understood air pressure, then it will be easy for you to understand the winds lesson. So let's start with the winds lesson. Again, this lesson we are going to divide into two videos. In the first part of the video, we are going to take information about the definition of wind, about the velocity of a wind. Then also we are going to take the information about the rotation of the earth and the direction of the winds. And in the second video, we are going to see in the detail the types of the winds. So let's start with the lesson, that is wind. Before I start with my explanation, I would like to tell you to do certain kind of a observation. Now due to lockdown period, you all are waiting at home. So you have to just observe the things in your surrounding. Just see outside of your home from your window. Which objects are moving and which objects are still? Why the moving objects are moving? Are they moving by their own? What is the reason behind it? How they are moving? And which are the objects which are not moving by their own? What is the reason behind it? Just observe it and write your observation in your classwork notebook. With the observation, we must have understood one thing, that is certain kind of a thing which is forcing the objects to move from one place to another place. Which is that thing? It is nothing but the air. Air is responsible for moving the objects from one place to another place. So moving air is called as the wind. In a simple language, moving air is called as the wind. Generation of a wind. The air pressure is not uniform on the surface of the earth, which we have studied in the last lesson. That's why I told you to revise that lesson first. We have studied the different pressure belt, how the pressure belts are formed, equator, on equator, low pressure belt, again high pressure, then low, non-polar region, again high pressure belt. This we have studied. And with that study, we have understood that air pressure is not uniform on the surface of the earth. Air moves from high pressure belt area to the low pressure belt area in a horizontal manner. Winds are generated due to this horizontal movement of air. Let's take information about the velocity of wind, means speed of the wind. The extent of difference in the air pressure is responsible to get affected on the velocity of the wind. Means difference in the air pressure affects the velocity of wind. If there is a less difference in the pressure, wind blow with a less speed or less velocity. And if there is a high difference in the air pressure, the speed of a wind is very high or the velocity of a wind is very high. Wind velocity is measured in a unit called as a kilometer per hour. What is the unit? Kilometer per hour is the unit to measure the velocity of a wind. Rotation of the earth and the direction of a wind. Very, very important point. The direction of wind is influenced by the rotation of the earth. means direction of the wind is decided with the help of a rotation of the earth. Winds get deflected towards the right of their original direction in the northern hemisphere and towards the left of their original direction in the southern hemisphere. I repeat, winds get deflected towards the right of their original direction in the northern hemisphere and towards the left of their original direction in the southern hemisphere. The rotation of the earth from the west to east causes the changes in the original direction of the wind. Let's conduct one activity. Okay, what you have to do? I am going to give you one diagram which you need to observe it very, very carefully. And this diagram is also given on textbook page number 22, diagram number 5.3. You need to observe this diagram very, very carefully and answer of what you have to write with the help of your observation in your classwork notebook. Which are the winds in the northern hemisphere that blow from the mid-latitudinal high pressure belt to the equatorial low pressure belt? What is the direction of the westerlies in the southern hemisphere? Which planetary winds blow from the mid-latitudinal high pressure belt to the subpolar low pressure belts in the southern hemisphere? Why is the direction of polar winds not the same in both the hemisphere? Name the wind that blow in the southern hemisphere. In which direction do the easterlies blow in the northern and southern hemisphere? These are the sixth question. The answer of the sixth question you need to write in your classwork notebook by observing the given diagram in the textbook page number 22, diagram number 5.3. On the basis of the direction of a blowing, the duration, the regions covered and the condition of the air, winds are classified into three types, that is planetary winds, local winds and seasonal winds. How we have divided these winds, types of winds, on the direction of a blowing, the duration and the regions covered. First type of a wind is planetary wind. Second type of a wind is the local winds. And the third type of a wind is seasonal wind. Mostly winds are known by the direction from which they blow or by region in which they blow. Now, in detail, the types of a wind we are going to see in the next video of this lesson. But basically, winds are divided into three types, that is planetary winds, local winds and seasonal winds. So, here we end with the first part of the lesson, wind. After my explanation, I am going to give you a small homework which is based on today's explanation. Till that time, thank you. Stay home, stay happy. Bye-bye.